about it too much because I get emotionally
Me too.
Now, do you remember when this was all red?
Vaguely.
It was that long ago, a few months ago.
Oh,
and that's Lanarkshire.
Now, Mike Russell one day said he drove from, is this Argyle down here, he drove from Argyle to somewhere up north.
Sorry.
And he didn't pass through any of the constituencies. Every constituency drove through the same
thing. In fact, people go from Glasgow to Edinburgh now and not pass through a Labour.
Well, you explained if you go to Edinburgh this year without going through anything.
Yeah. I think we should just shift what shift it off. We've seen that.
Another week, 3 seconds, just to maybe flatten out a little bit.
Of course. Oh, yeah.
That
would
be I waited up for my daughter's result, which are the last in Scotland. She calls herself last but not least. And she was supposed to be the last. So I got fed up waiting and went to bed. And when I woke up, I thought, God, I went to bed. Was it a dream? Do you think the whole thing was a dream? I don't know. I thought, was I'd imagined it?
No. And did you hear Nicola at the Glasgow Count when she made her speech? And she was on TV and she said, and Winnie, oh, I can't tell you this without crying. She said, Winnie, if you're watching right now, it took us 40 years, but we've got Hamilton back for you. Did you hear her saying that?
It was quite the area, completely from top to bottom.
But an open top bus and a sequined gown.
Really, it was quite emotional. And it all for me at that point in time. We got to it carried away. But it was really intrinsically Labour. They had worked the thing so thoroughly.
And we managed not to be one of the police stations. He said, I'm 71 years today. I've voted to Labour all my life. The last time I voted to the MP was in 1977. And this has been the second time.
Just maybe, will we look at this again? If you can't,
just pick it up. No, I'll just pick it up. I think it's very interesting.
No wonder.
Supposed to be okay, it's a bit drafty.
Well, my name is Winnie Ewing and I'm here to support our excellent candidate Anne McLaughlin, and I've been round the bit and I'm already able to say we're on a winning streak, and I'll be very, very surprised if we don't get this seat, because really the map of Scotland is coloured pretty yellow, and we want to make sure the yellow bits come right over this part of Scotland. And I think from what's seen today, it's going to do that very thing. And Anne is a very intelligent candidate and able for anybody. And that's what we want in politics, because we've had a hard time at the hands of Labourites in the past, but that's all changed. And it's now our era. And people need Scotland to be there to defend them, because the hardship they're dishing out to Scotland is still being done by those in power, unfortunately too many in power in the London scene. And they're holding on to every bit of power they can keep. And we need people like Anne to be down there, down in our new parliament, to fight for us every corner.